Everyone, welcome back to Lean Medical Billing. I'm Rajesh. I'm continuing with the management series. We'll start with statistical process control, right? See, the statistical process control is a very basic thing where you can identify how your process is going on. See, for example, you can understand whether your process is going in normal or is there any noise or any unwanted or unexpected things are happening in your billing. Okay, by seeing your value you cannot understand, by putting that into a statistical process control, it will be very easy to understand how your process is performing. Okay, for that I have one Excel sheet which I want to show you how to create your process control. See, for that I just got data, okay, for a month on month, what is the billing which we are doing for that particular practice. Okay, I just want to add that and then I'll tell you how to create your statistical process control chart. Okay, I just want to see here, by seeing this billed amount, okay, by month on month, I just want to know how my billing are getting performed. Okay, so to get the process control, first we need to create a mean here. See, as you know, the mean is nothing but your average. The average of, we'll take averages for 2018. Okay, this is your 2018 average. And then we will calculate. So this is the average which we are going to place it here. Okay, that is equal to your mean. So I'm just going to mark this as a mean. And this should be the standard value, or the value should not change for 2018. So this is your mean value. So once you got your mean, okay, try to create your UCL value, which is upper control limit value. So to do that, you have to understand what is your standard deviation. Okay, for the standard deviation, there is a formula available. You have to select the sample size, okay, STDEV.S, and then open a bracket and then select your billed amount, the complete segment, and then close it out. Okay, this is your billed amount, or this is your standard deviation. Okay, so this also will convert into dollars, and then this is your standard deviation. The UCL, the formula is mean plus 3 times of your standard deviation. So this also we will convert into a dollar symbol. See here, this value also the same, and we don't want to make any changes here. So I'm just make this value as a static, and then bring it here, and then bring your UCL value. The same way we are going to calculate our LCL. LCL is nothing but your lower control limit. See the lower control limit, the same formula. Okay, copy this. And then instead of plus, we are going to do here minus. Okay, when you're doing this, when your value is coming as negative, so instead of keeping that, you can keep this as a $0. But this is the way you're going to calculate your LCL. See, as I told you, here the values are changing for 2019. So I'm going to calculate again the average for 2019 here. This is my average. And this equal to, I'm giving this number to make this as a static, and this I'm keeping down the same number. So here the same formula. See, what I'm going to do here is, instead of that average, I'm changing the average here. Okay, this okay, and then this is a value here. Instead of D17, I am making this as a static one. And this will be my UCL, and the LCL will continue the same. Okay, you can try whether it is improving here or not. Okay, if you do the same thing here, instead of plus, try to do minus, and then see, since it's coming zero, so we are going to do the LCL as a zero. Okay, this is my table for a static process control, and this I'm trying to do a chart. Okay, this what my level. See, select all this and then go to your insert, and then here select the first table. Okay, if you see here, this is your static control. Okay, this is what your process is going up and down, and then here it is giving you the value where your things are going wrong or where it is started and how it is going. This is your mean, right? So I just want to add some label here so that we can understand easily. So this is my mean. This is my UCL value. Okay, and we didn't do any LCL here because it's a zero value. And this is my billing count, right? This is my billed amount. If you see here, the billed amount, okay, which started lesser than your mean, and then it's going up and up, right? So this is your billed amount. If you see here, okay, from the month of September or from August, it started growing up. Okay, so what you need to do is you have to see the point. Okay, when your points are going up, okay, there is some or some fortunate things are happening in this month. Okay, you just have to understand what's happening here and what is missed in the previous thing. This will give a better understanding of your process. Okay, what we need to be careful to bring our charges better, right? And if you see here, again from the November onwards, it started getting down, and then here it started going up to the peak. So by doing this mean chart, okay, you can understand how your billing process is going on. See, there is an up in the 2019, but even your billing is not in the static level. Okay, this is not only for your billing, or you can do your payment and then your billed amount or a charge amount, and even your production per associate level. Okay, everything you can do by this particular chart, which will give you a more understanding, okay, how your process is going on. Okay, so I hope you understand how to do this, and this will be very, very effective tool to monitor your billing progress. Okay, whether you are crossing your UCL or it is touching your LCL. Okay, this is a mean and how your business are running on an average, or it is going up periodically, ups and down. See, there are rules are available here. Okay, if any 3 points are continuously going up, it will show the forward trend, and there is a reason for that. If any 3 points are coming down, that also showing as a negative trend, there are also some reasons would be there. Okay, you have to understand the reason and you have to fix it, then you can reach out to the next level. Hope you understand this particular chart, the statistical process control chart. And if you like our program or like our training video, please like it, share it to your friends, and then subscribe our channel. Okay, we'll come back with a new video with a new management tool. Okay, thank you. Have a nice day. Bye.